So today I would like to share with you a new concept of personalized medicine, particularly in the context of targeted cancer care. Now, I've been working in this field for more than a decade now. Just to put it in perspective, since the time when I still had hair, which is a long time ago. And I also blame it for my premature hair loss and aging and so on. Now, putting that aside, what is cancer? You can think of cancer as a group of cells escaping any control, dividing indefinitely, and behaving erratically.
Yeah!
Right. Imagine the 60 or so people in the first row of this room. Suddenly, one of them is replaced by 100 people sitting in the same seat. You can see how much damage that will cause. This is cancer. Then imagine some of these 100 people slipping through this first row, going to other rows, also disrupting other rows. You can imagine how deleterious that would be. And that is what metastasis is all about. And it's very serious. Now, why do we have to talk about cancer? Why is cancer such an important topic? Well, because the frequency of cancer in the general population is approximately 40%. Meaning if you have a room with 300 people in it, 120 of them approximately will have some type of cancer sometime during their life. That's huge. It's a problem that affects everyone. Particularly in Lebanon, where things are not helped at all by rampant pollution, if you live up in the hills and you see the thick black small cloud covering the room most days of the year, you understand what I'm talking about. Out of control smoking, the lack of regulation, the lack of prevention, etc. So it's a big problem that needs a solution. Now, for the past half century or so, chemotherapy has been the most commonly used treatment for cancer.
Chemo.
Now, chemotherapy is the dumbest way to try and treat cancer because these molecules are toxic to all cells. They simply happen to kill cancer cells slightly faster than normal cells. I like to compare chemotherapy to the carpet bombing they used to use in World War II, whereby a whole city is being scattered in order to maybe destroy one next to it. So chemotherapy, as we know it, has reached its potential. There is no more future for it. And a new approach, a new strategy, is required to treat cancer. This new approach is called targeted cancer therapy. And it consists of identifying particular markers or characteristics that are present on cancer cells but absent on normal cells. Then to develop new drugs that selectively and efficiently target these markers, killing cancer cells while sparing normal cells. However, it goes further than that, because we now know that not all cancers are created identical, and definitely not all cancers are created equal. We now know that a particular cancer in a particular patient has different characteristics than the same cancer in a different patient. Therefore, the old concept of treating diseases is no longer applicable. And a new concept, a new approach of treating particular patients with particular characteristics of their disease is the new paradigm. This is personalized medicine. It's personalizing the approach to the characteristics of the patient. In terms of cancer therapy, it consists of having a battery of drugs targeted against different characteristics of the tumor. Then the patient would receive the drug that targets their own marker, and this is targeted cancer therapy. Personalized medicine, as I've just described it, is still a thing of the future. And we need at least a couple of decades for it to reach its full potential. However, several approaches are starting to apply this principle, to apply the targeted therapy principle. A classic example would be that of Herceptin for the treatment of HER2-positive breast cancer. In this case, the patient, if they pick the patients that have the marker, that have HER2, are treated with Herceptin, and only them, while the patients that lack Herceptin will never be treated with that drug. This is targeted cancer therapy. In this case, actually, HER2 is the driving force behind the cancer. And Herceptin, by blocking HER2, stops cancer development, and and patient survival is increased, and the patients are in full remission with continued treatment with Herceptin. This is the first step towards personalized medicine. However, it's still incomplete. Why? Because unfortunately for these other guys, we lack the knowledge regarding particular markers that they express, and we lack the means to effectively target those markers. So for these guys, there are no targeted therapies at this point, and they only have to go with traditional therapies. Once this is achieved, then we would have come a step forward, a step closer towards applying the full strength and the full extent of personalized medicine. Now, there are a lot of difficulties that are still facing this approach, not the least of which the identification of markers present on cancer cells but absent on normal cells. This is very hard to do. Also, developing drugs that can effectively target those markers. This is even harder to achieve. Another problem is the fact that pharmaceutical and biotechnology companies resist this paradigm because it leads to an exponential increase in the number of drugs that have to be developed, thus increasing the cost, while narrowing the range of patients that would benefit from those drugs, thus decreasing the revenue. Pharmaceutical companies tend to favor a more of a non-personalized cancer therapy approach, which consists of identifying a simple marker that's common to all cancers and come up with a drug that targets it. Whether this is going to work or not, or which approach is the best, well, I think the first one is the best, but that's a story for another day. Of course, like anything in science and in biomedical research, no one can claim sole ownership of an idea or a concept. And the same applies to this idea. There are hundreds and thousands of scientists working, for the most cases, till 4 in the morning, as we saw earlier, coming up with new strategies for the targeted therapy of cancer. We are still searching, and we slowly come up with new breakthroughs that are leading us forward down the road to targeted cancer therapy and personalized medicine. This, we hope, would have a significant impact on survival and quality of life in a whole range of cancers, and who turn them all into a more manageable chronic type of disease. Thank you.